Aquatic weeds can be beneficial to your pond, but when they grow out of control, they can be more than a nuisance. Weeds like algae, duckweed, and cattails not only hurt the look of your pond, but they can disrupt recreational activities, block sunlight, and steal nutrients. In this video, we'll go over some differences in aquatic weeds and some tips on how to control them. I'm Jason with Solutions Pest and Lawn. If you're new to us, we create these videos to help educate people like you about DIY pest control. If you want to learn more and find the right products for aquatic weed control, click the card in the top right corner of the screen or the links in the description below. Aquatic weed control can sometimes be difficult. There are many different types of aquatic weeds that can invade your pond, and sometimes an herbicide you might use for one weed might not be effective against another. So the first and most crucial step in controlling aquatic weeds is properly identifying the weed. If you already know which weed you have and want more in-depth help, please visit our website where you can find categories for common aquatic weeds and the best weed killers to get rid of them. Along with algae, aquatic weeds can be separated into three groups: floating weeds, submerged weeds, and emergent weeds. As their name suggests, floating weeds are those that float and move freely around the pond surface. Some common floating weeds are duckweed, bladderwort, and water hyacinth. Submerged weeds are aquatic weeds that grow and root underwater and will typically stay there for the majority of its life. Common submerged weeds you might see or feel are coontails, water milfoil, or curly leaf pondweed. And emergent aquatic weeds are the ones that you'll see popping out of the water. They're typically along the shoreline, but can extend towards the middle of the pond if it's shallow. Common emergent weeds are cattails, water lilies, and reed grass. You need to have an understanding of which weed or weeds you have in order to get proper control. The type of weed your pond has will determine which product you will need to use and how to apply it. Don't forget, visit our website for in-depth guides that can help you identify and treat for specific weeds. You can even send us a picture of the weeds in your pond at this email address, and we can identify it for you and suggest treatment options. Once you have identified the weeds, there are some things you need to consider before you begin treatment. First, you need to know the size of the pond. Measure the pond surface area and the depth. Knowing the size will help you when figuring out the mix rates. You will also need to consider if your pond is used for drinking, recreation, irrigation, or houses fish. Always read the label of any aquatic herbicide because some herbicides have water use restrictions. For instance, you might have to wait several days before you can drink treated water depending on your application rate. When it's time to treat, we recommend using either diquat or fluoridone herbicides. These professional-grade aquatic herbicides are great because they are formulated to treat many different floating, submerged, and emerged weeds. These aren't just used for ponds, but can also be used to treat lakes, reservoirs, canals, and others. Just be sure to read the label to make sure your type of body of water is listed. Diquat and fluoridone are both liquid aquatic herbicides. We generally recommend liquid herbicides because they can control weeds through spot and broadcast treatments and can be spread evenly with the pump sprayer. Follow label directions for proper mix and usage rates. Depending on the targeted weed and the water's depth, you can spray the herbicide over the water along the shoreline, spot treat emerged weeds, or broadcast spray over the water's surface. You can also use a product called Vision Pond Dye. This is a non-toxic dye that is safe for animal, human, and plant life. This will give the water a natural blue color, but also filters UV light to inhibit algae and weed growth. Follow the label directions for proper application rate and pour at the edge of the pond. The water's natural movement will disperse the dye. Important things to consider. Aquatic herbicides are most effective against active weeds. Be sure to make sure your applications are during warm, sunny days when rain is not in the immediate forecast. Consider using a fountain or other aeration device to create an oxygen-rich environment. And most important, only treat around 1/3 of the water at a time, waiting 14 days in between treatments. As the weeds die off, they can reduce the amount of oxygen in the water. Kill too many weeds at once, and it can deplete the oxygen in the water and kill the aquatic life. These are just some of the things that you can do to control and prevent aquatic weeds from invading your pond. Visit our website for in-depth guides that can help you identify and treat for specific weeds. We 100% guarantee that these products and tips we offer will get rid of your specific weed problem. And we offer same-day shipping to help you get control quickly. Solutions is a small family-owned business, and we rely on referrals from customers like you. So if you like this how-to guide, please share and tell your friends and family about us. Also, please don't hesitate to give us a call or shoot us an email. I'm Jason Baker with Solutions Pest and Lawn. Ask us how, then do it yourself.